I didn't.
A lot of no's.
No.
Shaking their head. Nobody would have thought.
No.
Well, that's where I want to start, is what led to that decision? Was it 2-3 years removed?
Two and a half.
2.5.
Yeah.
What made you say, it is time, I want to go back?
Well, I had just found out that the girls were coming back to the East Coast for their final nationals. And I thought, my impression was that it was like the last season of the entire show. And I think it was supposed to be.
I believe it was.
And that was very just... That was a moment for me because that was my whole childhood and I left so abruptly and never had proper closure that I felt like, wow, if I don't get proper closure now, if I don't get a final goodbye now, then when am I ever going to have that moment? So I talked to my mom and I was like, I think I want to go back.
And I could have fallen over in the kitchen. I was like, what? And she's like, I think I want to go back. And I'm like,
well, just for one episode. That's what that was it.
That was the plan. Yeah.
And then we went back and then another season showed up and I was like, well, I guess we're going back for another season.
Talk about kind of leading up to that, right? You're making this decision. There's so many different unknown things. Like, you know, who the new people are going to be. Yeah. Who's going to be there? Who's not going to be there? What's waiting for you when you walk in? How do you juggle all of those unknowns with this huge decision?
Well, the clip that you saw when we actually walked in the door for the very first time on that finale. Oh, hello. What you didn't see was Chloe standing outside the door for about 5 minutes. Like, she kept putting her hand on the door and she's like, I don't think I can do it. And
I was physically getting
sick. Yeah. She's like, I don't know if I can do this. I don't know if I can do this. And I'm like, you know what? We're here. Open the door.
Well, in my defense, I wasn't sure if my teacher, Abby, was going to be on the other side of that door, and I didn't know if I could handle that moment, to be quite honest. So I was like, I don't know if I can enter this environment again. And then I went in, and she wasn't there, and it was just, like, wonderful happiness. So it was good.
Well, that's one of those things, right, that you don't know, and that is a huge factor when you're making that call going in. You're rolling the dice in a very important part of the puzzle. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I imagine there were a lot of discussions had prior to that moment.
Yeah, there was a lot of discussions, but it was more about us and our journey and our story. I don't think that our story was quite over when we left because it was just somebody else made the decision for us to leave, meaning that it was such an unbearable circumstance that I no longer felt it was a good place for Chloe. Yeah. But I felt like our story needed to be finished. And I think, in a way, it was the best thing I ever did. The best thing I ever did was leaving the show when I did, because it was important for her. And as a mom, I needed to leave. But the best thing I ever did was going back, because we got a lot of closure. And now when I look back on Dance Moms, and I think that you can say the same, I'm going to look back and really love what happens. Because I think you guys are going to love what you're going to see coming up this season. Because if I was like an Academy Award winning writer, I couldn't have written the way things all come to fruition. And I think everybody especially people who've watched the show since the beginning, you guys are going to love to see what happens to these girls, because I did.
That's like the definition of closure. That's a really good place to be in, to be able to look at it and think that. What's something that you were really hopeful and optimistic and excited for that you thought was waiting for you when you got back there and you were lucky and it was the friends, the relationships?
For sure the friends, because it was, as I said before, I left so abruptly that my friendship, it was kind of severed with the girls, but it wasn't, because it was awkward when I ran into them and it just wasn't the same as it was before. And so after going back to the show, then I really got to rebuild that friendship and I got to dance again. I hadn't danced like that in about a year, so it was kind of weird going from not dancing at that level to dancing at that level on national television.
And she struggled. You did struggle.
Yeah, I did struggle, and I'm sure people will make comments about how my dancing has changed, but people are always going to say things. And so it was, I was very excited for various reasons. And just like, as my mom said, to have that, to be able to look back in 30 years and say, I'm so happy I went back, because now I have a happy memory from Dance Moms rather than just bad and negative and drama and ugly tears. So.
Forget about what other people are going to say. How do you feel about how your dance has evolved and changed over time?
I've been through...
Is that a big question? Is that too much to...
No. I mean, I was dancing every single day for like 4 years of my life, and then I stopped and I competed for a year, and then I really took a break. I focused on acting. I've done, I think, five films now, so it's been really incredible. So dance hasn't been the main focus of my life anymore, so really it did affect how I was dancing when I went back to the show. But I'm happy and I'm proud of what I've done so far, so I guess that's
I'm proud, because she could have quit when we left the show for the first time, she could have quit. I gave her the option to quit. And she said, no, I want to continue to dance. And she knew going back into Dance Moms what the conditioning and what the dance requirements were going to be. And she knew that she wasn't quite where the other girls were. And she's like, you know what? I'm going to do it for myself. And as a mom, like, and she's like, I don't care what anybody says. I don't care what people say. And she's like, I'm going back to do it for me. And I said that that was like your encore. I said you had your finale, but that was your encore. And so I was very proud and emotional and excited to watch her.
Out soon.
And there is nothing in this world I love more than watching Chloe dance. We all know that, right? Like that face, and I get all like, oh. And it was really wonderful for me to see her up there again and to watch all of the girls, because I've watched those girls grow up.
And I think everyone's going to really like the Nationals number. That one's fun.
Yeah, there's a lot. There's a lot of fun stuff that's coming up.
Wouldn't be doing my job if I didn't ask you, Chrissy. Was there anybody you were least looking forward to seeing when you went back?
Well, let me think. Who did I not want to see? Well,
you know, and let's put a positive spin on it. Was there somebody that you thought about that, but then by the end of it, you were like, you know what? I'm glad I saw that person. I'm glad we got to have that conversation.
No, because that person I did not have a conversation with ever.
Got it.
Okay. However, I was, no talking. Not sad about it either.
Got it.
But I was really excited to see like Holly and Jill, like regardless of what, you know, you see on television, you know, those women are women that I've known forever. And I was excited to see them. And okay, I'll tell you guys like a little fun story. So the moms all have a text chain, all of the moms. Like, I shouldn't say all of the moms. Here's who's on the text chain. It's me, two of our producers, Kelly. Gotta have Kel. Holly, Jill, Kira, and Melissa. And we're all in a text chain. It's a big chain. And no one would have ever thought that you'd see that text chain. And the stuff that goes back and forth on that text chain is hysterical. Like, it's hysterical.
Can you share anything?
Well, we share a lot of old pictures. Okay. We share a lot of news articles that are currently out about other cast members. Wonder who. It's really nice because, you know, everyone thinks that we all hate each other and this and that. But at the end of the day, those women are really women who nobody's going to understand. Like, we were just moms from Pittsburgh wearing like TJ Maxx dresses and going on TV. And we're like, what's happening on our kids? And you guys are the ones who fell in love with the girls and turned this show that no one ever thought much of into really, it was a cultural phenomenon.
For sure.
And I can't thank you enough. Because you've changed our lives, and I'm speaking for all of the moms. So thank you.